Hear another story.
Yes, of course. You've been waiting a long time for this, so how about a special one? This story is very strange and very nasty, but somewhat nostalgic. Do you think you can be a good girl and listen all the way to the end?
Is it a scary story?
It might be. But it's also a very important story. If you don't want to hear it, I can tell you a different story.
No, I want to hear it. This way, I won't be scared.
Will you turn on the TV then? Leave the sound down, like always. Now, listen. This is important. At times, we must purge things from this world because they should not exist. Even if it means losing someone that you love.
Sorry to keep you waiting. It will start soon.
It's about time to get started.
Zach. Zach, can you hear me? It's me, York. If you can hear my voice, could you respond? Ah, good. I thought you went to sleep. Zach, don't be surprised. The crime took place out in the country this time. Let's take it slow. Okay, Zach?
Sure, that's one way of looking at it, but it's totally wrong. Listen, they both need each other. It's called interdependency, and they both know it. Yeah, I know. He does terrible things to Tom. Nasty, even sadistic things. But that's fine, as long as that's what Tom wants. Think about it. His actions. He's always asking for it. It's his partner's job to fulfill that need, and Jerry knows that. Proof? Well, in the Tom and Jerry show, they live with each other. Hello? Hello?
Back. I can't believe the Bureau still can't get me a satellite phone.
These puppies are making me go to another town in the boondocks again.
Well, I'll be a happy camper, even if it ends up being a waste of time. At the very least, it'll get me out of the cramped city for a while. Right, Zach? The perpetrator from the last case really was something. Who'd have thought there'd be razors laced into your nails? Crazy. Just crazy. Well, at least I now have a scar to show off. See this? I got this when I arrested the Catwoman wannabe. Women, they're crazy. Don't you agree, Zach? Zach, there goes the civilized world. Looks like we're being welcomed. Zach, I'll let you handle the meet and greet. Through a lot of crazy situations, but that one takes the cake. It's the first time I've been attacked so directly. Zach, can you give me a logical explanation about what that was? Never mind, don't answer. Life is fun because of the mysteries. Right, Zach? Great. great. Amazing. bullseye. Great. Amazing. Bullseye. Great. There's definitely something in this town. Do you feel it, Zach? My coffee warned me about it.
Yesterday morning, the milk I poured in my coffee made a sign. It said, "Tomorrow you'll arrive in a place that will change your fate."
Now you were very late. I didn't think you'd keep me waiting in the rain for so long.
FBI Special Agent Francis York Morgan. Please, just call me York. That's what everyone calls me.
Agent York?
Good, that's good. Are you the sheriff?
No, I'm Deputy Sheriff Emily Wyatt. George, he's the sheriff. He went looking for you, actually. He should be back soon.
I see.
If you don't mind me asking, did you walk all the way here?
My car broke down, that's all.
She's easy on the eyes. Definitely worth a trip to the primitive world.
By the way, don't mention anything about what happened back there. She'll think you're a psycho. Don't want that, do we, Zach?
Welcome to Greenvale. I'm the sheriff, George Woodman. Call me George.
FBI Special Agent Francis York Morgan. Please, just call me York. That's what everyone calls me.
Could you tell me why the FBI is so interested in a small-town homicide?
Let's just say it's a personal interest in killers of young women. I'm always looking for new sample cases to help me with my profiling.
Both our superiors have cleared this with each other. You can remain in command. You don't have a problem with this, do you?
No. No problem. Just want to set things straight. Our small town has its share of problems. I'm the one fixing them one by one and maintaining peace and order. You can have your profiling sample, but I need you to understand that.
Of course.
Of course. By the way, George, I had a little accident with my car. Could you send someone to take care of it? Oh, and my clothes and luggage are still inside.
All right. Don't worry. I'll get my assistant, Thomas, to take care of it. Do you need anything else?
Thanks. That'll be all. Well then, I think I'll rest up first at the hotel. Then I'll join you on your investigation.
Don't know how to say that. We really don't need your help. Unlike some of your corrupt city police officers, I play it by the book. I hope you'll come to appreciate that, Agent Morgan. And we'll handle the investigation. You just think of this as a vacation. Take it easy. Enjoy the nature here. You don't have to be a tree worshiper to appreciate the wildlife here.
Let's reassess the situation. There are no cavemen here. We're as far forward as the Middle Ages. And we've just met the king.